Good morning and welcome to a sunny day here at the Sunseeker shipyards in Poole. My name is Sean Robertson, I'm Sales Director of Sunseeker International, and I'd like to give you a brief view this morning of this gorgeous 76 yacht here that I'm standing on. Now the 76 has been with us now for just over 2 years and gives incredible space and light. And on screen now you should be able to see the beautiful lines coupled together with the glazing, not only let into the hull, but also through the superstructure to let that light in and giving you that ability that even when you're inside the boat, of feeling at one with the water and the environment outside. Now going back down to the more of the actual basics of the spec here, she's equipped with the twin 1550 MAN V12 engines. This gives it a top speed of approximately 33 to 34 knots and an easy cruise at anywhere from 16, 17 knots all the way through to 30. Now, fuel consumption is obviously key when you're planning these more long distance cruising, or if you just want to be staying on board locally for a few weeks and don't want to be popping back into the fuel dock every day. So again, hopefully you can see on screen now the fuel consumption chart. Have a good look through and you'll see just how efficient she is. Either keeping her off plane at about 11 to 12 knots, fully stabilized at a great, comfortable, long distance, slow cruise speed, or once you're onto plane, probably finding the most economical to be around about 21, 22 knots. But obviously that's your choice. She'll run, as I said earlier, happily at any speed, all the way through to 33 or 34 knots. If we come back to the stern, where we're standing here, one of the key features throughout the Sunseeker range now, not just on the 76, is this massive hydraulic bathing platform. Now this can take a weight of up to about 500 kilos, and equating that into a tender size, it's around a 4 to 4.5 meter sport jet, like the Williams sport jet style tender. It's a fantastic option. Launch the tender off very easily with the push of the control buttons the other side, but then you've got this on-water play and relaxation area. Hold it just above water level, easy to get on and off, or just below, so that means you can actually swim on and off the platform. It's a great feature and something that I think is key now throughout the range. You'll see that you've got integrated in the boarding ladder, cleats, so once you've got your tenders and toys in the water, they can be tied off. And all very importantly, when she's down, you've got steps both sides that lead down from the cockpit. Coming across on any boat, one of the key things that we always get asked about is storage. You know, where can I store all the toys, all the equipment I need on board? And I just highlight just one area here, right at the stern. Now, if we open this locker up, you can see that that is probably just over a meter deep by probably close to 2.5 meters in width. Fully accessible, this side opens as well. Now, for getting water toys, water sports equipment, sea bobs, everything into there, that's a great bonus to have and such, you know, easily accessible as well. Coming down on this port side, we have another locker here that opens up hinged from the top. And this again gives you a great storage space for mooring equipment, fenders, ropes, etc., and has built in a fantastic shower. So again, once up, once you've come out of the water, use the toys, you can shower off here easily. So let's come back across to the starboard side. And here hidden, you have the crew access. Now we say crew, I imagine a lot of clients will be using this just as much as an extra guest cabin, because the finish, the amenities inside are just akin to the rest of the boat. Two single berths, a great ensuite, small seating area, TV, audio. And you'll notice with this door, the way it's actioned is that if you have got crew or someone staying in this cabin, and you're in harbour, the door can be open and it does give some privacy. So again, the way this works gives that little extra bit of capability of use. We'll mention it later, but from the crew cabin, you do have direct access to the engine room as well, which I think is a great feature, alleviating the use of the cockpit hatch, particularly if you're sat there with guests, with friends, you don't want to have to go through that floor. So the access from the crew cabin is a fantastic option. So let's go on up through the steps here. On the port side, we have the passerelle. So passerelle that will extend well over a meter past the bathing platform, obviously essential for med use. And you'll see on the starboard side here that your shore services, so shore power, water, TV leads, etc., are recessed through into these opening steps. So that again, you've not got, you know, the ugly cables dragging up over the steps to a locker. So again, makes a great deal of difference. Small feature, but I think very important. Coming up into the aft cockpit, we have some beautifully designed safety gates. I'll just put that one across so you can see. So again, once you're on board with your friends, guests, maybe young children on board, gives an extra level of security and very easily used. Just lift and then slide back into the lock position. Great access to the mooring equipment, oversized cleats, stern windlasses, and a nice integrated locker that the ends of the ropes can be fed into. So again, they're not coiled or cluttered on the deck. And you'll see the stern windlass is actually operated by a foot switch. So again, leaving you both hands to work the lines themselves. Again, small detail, but make a big difference. Coming into the aft cockpit, often an area that's forgotten on a flybridge yacht, but you can see here what a great space you have. Fully protected, you have a camper or privacy screen that can go in the stern here. Again, so if you're in the med, stern to the quayside, put the privacy screen up, gives you a bit more privacy from people peering in from the quayside. Beautiful seating area with a folding table. So whether you're dining or having drinks in the evening, easily folds out or folds away to give a bit more multi-use. I particularly like this forward L-shaped seating. Now, excusing the video, we don't have the cushions out to give it its full effect, but sat here with the windows either side, even though you are protected and enclosed, even when the boat's running, you've still got great visibility out, full of light. And of course here, you need to be able to serve drinks, refreshments, refrigeration. So in the cabinet here, you'll see you've got an ice maker and refrigerator. And all of this really neatly integrates with the floating staircase to the flybridge deck that we'll take a look at later. Lighting is discreetly hidden away. So two spotlights over the table, just to give some light so you can see what you're doing here. But then you'll see you've got these integrated and hidden strip lighting, LED strip lighting into the ceiling, and obviously full AV control in the aft cockpit here as well. Now, when you use a boat, all of this becomes a great entertainment space. But again, I think for years, particularly on flybridges, you tended to have an interior space and then an exterior cockpit. What we've tried to do with the 76 is still keep this. So you have the normal patio sliding door that fully closes off. But what you'll see is the floor is completely flush. You've got a drainage system here, so any water that is in the cockpit can't ingress into the cabin space. But you've got a door system that either opens normally, as you see now, to allow access, or you can actually move both of these panels all the way across to the starboard side. So that actually then it's hidden under the staircase and you've got a completely open entertainment space. Now, to give you some idea, from here, I can see all the way through the helm screen and to the bow. And even on this interior space, you're looking at close to 15 meters, 16 meters of space. So a great entertainment area, giving you multi-zones to use with your family and guests. So that's given you a brief overview of the 76. But let's go and look at this one now in some more detail. So I've invited here today Chris Head, sales director of Sunseeker London, and if we come through now into the cabin area, let's go and speak to him about the specific options on this yacht. So before we actually sit down with Chris, let's just look at this environment inside this yacht. The colours are just stunning. In fact, when I walked in this morning, although we see a lot of yachts, it really took my breath away how it's just stands out. The mixture of the colours, the materials, together with the light coming from the windows is just amazing. And you know what? It's going to be so easy for a client to make this look more classic, more contemporary. However they want to dress the boat is going to be very easy to do. So the team on putting this material match together have done an amazing job. Now earlier I said about how you could see all the way through to the helm screen and beyond, and the feeling of space that gives you, and most of that is achieved by the galley. So although it is semi-enclosed with this glass panel, again with the large windows, the windows opposite where Chris is sat here on our left, it really just brings that space in. And yet when the galley's not being used like today, it almost blends in as a perfect piece of furniture. Beautiful tops, the refrigerator, freezer is all hidden away. Even the way the cook center and the sinks are, it's there, it's obvious it's there, but it's beautifully hidden. And I think this really lends itself to the ambiance of this yacht, of this open, real spacious feel. And yet you've still got practical space all the way through, storage all the way through this lower cabinet unit, wine cooler, dishwasher, you know, so all the amenities that you're ever going to need, whether you're on board for the day or for an extended cruise. Importantly here, one little feature as well, is you'll see this panel here has got the different framing. That is actually a drop window. So if you are fully open during the day in the med, and a lot of clients will like this, and you don't want to have the air conditioning running because you've got all the doors open, you can still get airflow. Window here, door at the helm, doors open, and you've got great throughput of air all the way through the saloon space. So let's have a good look at this inner helm area. So you've got two beautiful Bezanzone seats that really hold you in place, because let's not forget, she's a performance boat. Now we talked about stabilizers and how that'll keep her beautifully steady at anchor, and also underway if you are running, you know, those days you get caught out, there's a bit of a swell, it takes out that rolling, any of that rolling motion that nobody really likes in a boat. But it doesn't take away the feel that you get when you're at the helm. And with the controls easy falling to your right hand here, the steering is exceptionally light. So I mean, you can go lock to lock beautifully, and she tracks through the water exceptionally well. It's an efficient hull, a performance hull. It's also a very dry hull. You know, we see a lot of boats with spray coming over the screen and everything. With the chine setup on the hull of the 76, you won't get that. It's a hard chine at water level, which pushes the spray flat and away from the hull. And also then the lift strakes, the chines running through on the V, again, helped not only just lift the boat, but push the water flat away. So a great experience at the helm. But okay, you've had your fun, you've gone out and impressed your friends, but now you're doing your longer cruise and you want everything at hand. So you'll see here your touch sensitive Simrad screens. But again, thinking about how they're used, when you're underway, often touching the screen is a little bit difficult to be accurate. So we do put in as well a manual control here, you'll see on the right hand side. Then coming through, you've got the two screens. So that works in the way of having potentially plotter on one, radar on the other, a split radar plotter on each one at different levels of zoom. So it really gives you flexibility. And if you look far to the left, you've then got a third Simrad screen matching the others, but this one gives all the boat systems. So this gives you an overview of what the boat's doing, fuel, water, lighting, bilge pumps, all the controls for air conditioning, etc., are all on the screen here. So you can see exactly what's happening whilst you're underway. And also change settings as and when you need to. Below that, we have easy access to controls for the stabilizers, main engines, autopilot, and, you know, little features like you've got the air conditioning outlets here. So again, gives you some cool breeze if you are sat inside. And then finally on the port side, the helm here, nice storage locker because you've always got lots of things at the helm, be it phones, be it tablet computers, binoculars, whatever you have. And you'll see in there as well that you've got the charging points that everybody needs now to keep everything topped up and ready to go. And let's not forget, plenty of cup holders as well. Very important when you're boating in the Med. So we've been out for the day. We've either anchored or we're coming back into harbour. And you've got to have that easy access and give you ability of getting to the exterior of the boat. And here you'll see you've got an electrically actuated pop-out door. Simply turn the switch, push the button, unlocks, and it's a carbon-based door, so very light, push out, and you've got straight access to the side decks. Very important if you're helming, particularly coming into a marina, that you've got that ability to get outside and have a view, or if you just want easy access to the foredeck. So, talked about some of the features, we've talked about the outside, talked about the console area. Chris has given us a great overview of some of the options on board. Let's go downstairs now and see what it's like if you are going to be staying on board for extended periods and what the accommodation space is like. Okay, so even getting to the lower deck accommodation, you're coming through, boy, it's quite a feature staircase with the glazing, the woodwork. You'll see even halfway down, you've got this beautiful window out to the hull side that not only lets the light in and a feature, but it obviously lights up this whole hallway space. And we've tried to really think about the client being on board. So little things here, you've got halfway down the stairs, maybe could be a linen cupboard, towel cupboard, or just general storage. And one key thing, which I love on this boat, is if you get down to the bottom of the stairs, one thing we always hear from clients is, where are we gonna put the bags? Where are we gonna put the suitcases? So we've tried to make use of every bit of space on the 76. And if you lift up here, on a gas strut, so very easy to do. You've got a massive storage space there. You can't see it fully, but it goes right the way to the hull side and is probably the best part of the, 70, 80 centimetres high. So easy storage with larger suitcases, bags, that can be tucked away safely and not be in the way in the cabins or in the wardrobes themselves. Now, into the lobby area, great space. The mirror works really well, so you don't feel enclosed. Great storage lockers here on the inner surface. And before we go into the cabins, I just point out, you'll see through the floor here that you've got these very discreetly covered hatches with a pull ring. Now, on any boat, there's services, there's service items, there's just general inspection that you need to do in the bilges. And there's nothing worse if you've got a beautifully fitted carpet and then you've got to try and pull a carpet up, pull an underlay up, and get through to another hatch and balance it all. With this, you'll see as we run through the lower deck, you've got these conveniently situated hatches all the way through. A little practicality that at purchase seem, you might even ignore them, but once you're using the boat, will become really important to you. So great width in the companionway here. And as we move forward, you see again, another large mirror on the bulkhead here, which really opens the space up. And we come first of all into what is actually, unbelievably, the third cabin. So this is a queen size berth, great size cabin, huge picture window, great materials. Again, it feels very light, very airy. You've got everything in here, audio visual, desk area or vanity area. You'll see in the large windows, you've got an opening port. So again, if you're on board, myself included, some of us don't like to have the air conditioning running all the time during the day, sometimes even at night if it's a beautiful evening. So you can get the airflow all the way through the boat. You've got great storage under the bed. There's drawers on either side. So again, easy to access. You know, you haven't got to try and lift the mattress and lift the hatch. It's all accessed from the sides. Air conditioning control, reading lights. And what we can see here behind the access door here, you've got the doorway through to the ensuite as well. So a great size cabin. Coming further forward, we've got a secondary door into that ensuite. So this can be used as the day head, you know, obviously for guests on board just for the day. And then we come into what is the, in effect, the fourth cabin. Again, beautiful size. I mean, this isn't just a children's cabin. It's a great size, doesn't feel cramped, really light. I mean, considering we're in England, not in the Med, the light coming through the window is fantastic. TV on the bulkhead here, aircon controls again. And a key feature here is these two beds slide together. So lift up the little wooden spaces here. You've got a track and the bed are slide together to make a double bed. So again, depending on which guests you've got on board, it gives you that flexibility. Wardrobe space, again, very, very good size. All lit, and obviously you've got your controls for the audio visual down below. And then obviously doorway through to the ensuite, which is a great size. I mean, the actual shower, again, good size, heated towel rail. You know, for such a small cabin space, you know, or the smaller cabin space on the boat, I think there's a great space still to use. So back into the companionway, come through the last doorway into what is the VIP cabin, the forward cabin, which is just a really interesting space. So many textures and materials, features on in the cupboards all the way down the sides here. You'll see you've got locker space, opening ports in the big windows either side, overhead blind, and it's a great size bed. I mean, it really does work well. And being raised to maximize the space, because you've got to raise it up away from the V of the hull, you've got the convenient step both sides so that you can easily get actually into the bed. On the aft bulkhead, great sized TV, vanity unit on this aft port side here, and then open up here to another fantastic sized wardrobe space. Again, it's a very easy boat to stay on board for extended periods. You know, if you think of the cruising capability with the real good range of speed you've got, coupled together with the stabilizers and the equipment that Chris talked us through earlier in terms of options for comfort on board, and then look at this space. I mean, this is a great boat to be away for the summer on. Coming back, finally, we've got the fourth ensuite again, which is good size, great shower, great storage, and a real benefit to this cabin. So we've talked through probably all of your friends and your family space. Now, as the owner, obviously there should be a feature suite. And this is exactly what we find going aft here down the corridor. Now, this, I mean, it just blows you away. You get the full beams. You're in the beamiest part of the yacht. You've got windows, the full height of this space, plus the full length of the cabin, which lets so much light into here. And just look at the floor space. I mean, we've got a king-size bed with storage underneath, a relaxing breakfast come table area over on the starboard side. I mean, huge storage, drawers, vanity space on the port side. And still, it feels like you can have a party with the floor space you've got down here. Just absolutely fantastic. Forward bulkhead, TV, audio visual, speaker system, surround sound speaker system built in. This beautiful lighting again that's let into the ceiling. So, you know, multiple modes on the lighting, from spotlights over the vanity and the breakfast space, hidden lighting behind these pelmets, and then the overhead LED strip lighting. I think we mentioned already, we've got great storage, again, under both sides of the bed. Very easy to access, you know, no lifting up a bed, a mattress, etc. And then coming aft, it's almost quite hidden here. You've got another open walkway through into an incredible wardrobe space again. I mean, there's three separate lockers here, full height hanging, half height hanging, and then shelf storage, two brick safe in here as well. So again, no problem with storing away all your clothes for a extended cruise. And then the doorway to the head is nicely hidden. Let's get some lights on in here. And you'll see the head itself, twin sinks. Again, fantastic storage. I mean, the storage in this 76 all the way through that we've seen from the stern is just fantastic. And then over to a real, you know, great size shower on the starboard side. Glazed doors to keep the area nice and dry. Towel heater conveniently located here, and obviously a frosted window to the outside. You'll see the shower, you've got an overhead rain dance type head and a loose head here as well. Just a great space. I mean, it really completely hidden from the main cabin, but a great ensuite space. And I think just one little thing, I mean, we talked about little details that make a difference. And if you just look forward here on this bulkhead, I'll shut the door. Again, just a silly thing, but a full height mirror. The amount of times, you know, we get that request and we're just, you know, one thing we try and do with all the boats is listen to what the clients tell us. And these little features we try and build in all the way through. So conveniently located sockets, full height mirrors, storage, you know, the flexible reading lights rather than just something that's fixed, is really important that these little details at this stage make all the difference to the owning experience. I think we've had a really good look now at the outside of the yacht, the deck space, walking through the saloon and the accommodation space. But this, you know, if you're boating in the Med, the key areas are obviously the outside entertainment spaces, the foredeck and the flybridge. Let's go and have a look at these. Transitioning to the foredeck from the aft cockpit here, first thing that hits you is the size of these walkways. Look at it, I mean, it's easy access, great full height railings and bulwark all the way through. So you feel really safe and you've got the family on board, you know, safety is key. Down here on both sides, port and starboard, you've got the fuel lockers. Stupid little things you'll see is this, just this little plate at the bottom. So if you do get a little bit of spillage, it's not going to get down onto the side deck. And remember, these are both port and starboard. Another little feature. Great. These little details make all the difference. You'll see in the deck here, you've got a recessed plate, stainless steel with the deck drain underneath. Now, why this is important, at the end of the day, coming back into harbour, you're going to want to wash the boat down, but often you'll probably still have the family and guests in the aft end of the boat. And what it means is that water from that forward end, off of the windscreen, off of the side, off the coach roof, is not going to run into that aft deck. Little details, but make all the difference. You've got a side access door. So again, if you are coming side two, you've got direct access to a quayside, which again, certain markets won't use, but is important in others. And again, you just continue with this great walkway, great railings. You've got LED lights running all the way through the side deck here. And even as you transition forward, often where you'll have railings coming down, you've got great height. Again, a feature not to miss here is you'll see subtly how the combing here drops down. Now, although that's just a great look from the outside, what it also means is these windows that you'll see in the saloon here, you've got direct water view from the inside to out. So again, a design feature on the outside, but it actually has a practical use as well. Coming forward, what I've done today is actually left the cushions out on purpose. It's just much easier for you to then see what a great space this is. Now, first of all, you've got seating, sunbathing, seating where around a table, the multi-function use is quite amazing. Now, underneath the actual main U-shaped seating here, you see you've got four huge storage lockers. You've got a seat back that folds forward, and then a canopy comes up to give you a wind and sunshade during the day if you want it. On this forward seating, again, two lockers. And again, we've taken and looked at how we got sunshade. So you've got sockets, both port and starboard side, a drop-in parasol unit, which gives you great shade if you want it over the seating and or the sunbathing. But we thought about, okay, where do you store it? So both port and starboard sides, a tubular locker where you can store the parasol away very easily, keeping it nice and clean and tidy and keeping the deck space clear. Drinks holders, phone holder, odds and sods, books, refreshments. You haven't got to go back to the cockpit, back to the saloon. You've actually got fridges both sides here on the foredeck. Keep them stocked up. It'll keep the guests very happy. You can see here, you've actually got the light of the deck light through into the forward cabin. See, again, extra light going into that cabin, but it's thickened up, so no problem on walking on at all. Now, what is a surprise here? You've got all of these storage lockers underneath, probably for smaller items, but maybe then you want to get some larger storage, maybe the covers, cushions, whatever. Port and starboard, lift this up. You've got two massive vented spaces. Just, it's incredible the storage space you've got all the way through this yacht in all areas. Works exceptionally well, and it's just practical. Again, you know, you never really know how practical it is until you start using a boat, but it's vital. Coming forward, even at this area, you'll notice you've got rails all the way around, even right at the bows. So if you're looking when you're anchoring, when you're coming into harbour, seeing where lines are, you've got great practicality and safety all the way around. Two massive anchor locker accesses here. Again, you can be doubly used for extra fender storage. And you'll see here, you've got an oversized anchor assembly, both foot switches and a hand control that's stowed inside the locker. And obviously double cleats, easy access fairleads. So whether you're med mooring with the two lines coming in from the forward, easy access to the cleats, or if you're alongside like we are here, again, great protection and easy access for the ropes. So I hope you agree with all the space, sunbathing, seating, dining potential, shade, or full sun. And let's not forget full audio control up here on the bow as well. It's a great space, but probably not the primary exterior entertainment space. So with that in mind, let's go aft and now up onto the flybridge. So, up to the flybridge. Again, those steps are so easy. Great handholds, great size steps. Looks good, but very practical to use. You've got a great railing, you come up to the top here, but also this hatch. Not only does it keep the water out, but once you're up here, you can drop that back down and it stops, you know, particularly if you've got younger children, just guests that are new to the boat, stops them from, you know, accidentally slipping down into that space. So look at the size of the seating. I mean, it's huge. I don't know if the scale comes across on the camera, but, you know, to sit 8 or 10 people here would be simplicity. You could probably make it more than that. And then you've got a secondary seating area further forward. Again, you'll see lockers here. Huge locker space all the way around the seating group. And then this table, if you are going to dine, which I think, you know, probably be the most popular place to dine on the yacht, pull the supports out, and then you can open up both of these big leaves on the table. Again, great. You could even put two director's chairs here to increase that dining capability all the way around. And let's not forget, Chris mentioned earlier the options on the boat, and one of the key ones is the hardtop. Now, what this gives you is, at the moment where we have it closed, gives you complete shade over this space. So fantastic when you're dining, or maybe in the evening when it gets a bit damper and everything, you know, it's great to have it closed. Of course, push of a button and you can slide this back, stop it in any position. So if you just want a bit more air through, a bit of sunlight through in certain areas, or sliding all the way back to give you full sun over the table area. Maybe once you've had your lunch and you want to relax just with some drinks afterwards. So coming forward, again, the storage continues. Another locker here. And we come into what, again, looks like another seating area. And again, excuse the cushions, but we thought for this film, it was easier to show you all the function. So you've got a small drinks cockpit table here, but you'll notice with the clamp, this can be lifted out easily. So why would you do that? Well, quite simply, lift this hatch, lift the secondary hatch that folds over, and you now have, with the table out of the way, a huge sunbathing space. Even with a lift up head support here, back support, so you can sit here at an angle if you want, depending on where the sun's moved around to in the day. And even when you're running, I mean, what a fantastic place to lay led out against the backrest, running forward. I mean, just a stunning place to be. Drinks, refreshments. Again, we've added a drawer refrigerator under the console here. So again, although your main refrigeration is downstairs, you've got the option of keeping that full during the day. You'll see the reverse brake screen. It gives a good look when you look at the side profile, but also when you're running, it does push the air up and over. So again, if you're sat in this space or led out in this sunbathing area, it's completely protected from the wind, which again is a great bonus when you're running. Coming to the helm, we've got two fully adjustable in height and reach pilot seats here. The repeat of downstairs with twin Simrad touch sensitive screens, repeating the information downstairs, and not just repeating, you obviously got full control here as well. Full control over autopilot, stabilizers, engine instrumentation, thrusters. So again, you'll probably find most clients will be docking the boat from this station when they come into harbor, because you've got a great view. I mean, you can see to the bow, great view down the starboard side, and with the hatch open from here, I can actually see the stern quarter of the bathing platform. So for that med mooring, you know, from this helm position, you've got a great view along the boat. And if you do need to see the other side, very quick, pop across, you can see here and back to the helm. So very, very good control area. Obviously the wheel is all adjustable, so you can get a great, more, you know, comfortable driving position. And as I said earlier, full control over all the functions that you're ever going to need from this console area. So if we come back, one thing we didn't talk about when we came up the stairs was obviously the wet bar area. Now, you'll see in the floor here, this boat has got the option of the two stools, which again make a, you know, it's a beautiful area to sit, have your drink maybe in the, as the sun goes down in the evening. And coming round into the wet bar, obviously tap and sink here. Underneath you can't see, but we have ice maker, refrigerator, and then lifting the tops up, another huge cold box. And this is a cooled chilled box. So this will, you can put drinks in and it will chill them down, or you could fill it with ice at the beginning of the day and the cooling plate will keep that ice then for you all day long, keep the drinks cold. And then under the side, something which now a lot of clients are using is the barbecue up in this space. Nice place, you know, you put some beautiful prawns and steaks on there and it's a great way to finish off the day. Full audio on the flybridge with separate control. So it's something worth mentioning that with the system that's on board, you have got either a party mode, which will play the same source of music all the way through the yacht, or it can be split so that you have different music on the bow, on the interior, on the flybridge and aft cockpit. So it gives you a lot of flexibility of what can be done. Going further aft behind the seating is just a massive space that really any client can, you know, really work out themselves what's important to how they use the yacht. Now, a lot of people will just have loose, maybe sun loungers and seating here, you know, some beautiful teak furniture. We have others that, as Chris mentioned earlier, as an option, we can put a crane and a jet ski here. And you'll see that the rails already have the modification where you can lift these rails out to give you the ability of launching the jet ski. And we've even had requests for sunbathing and spa tubs. So a very flexible space. Give you some idea, it's virtually getting on for 5 meters wide by over 3 meters deep. So a great entertainment space. And what you can't see is on the aft edge of the hardtop here, again, push button, and you've got an electrically extending sun canopy to give this space some shade if you want it during the day.